Okay, so I wasn't recording, or I thought I was recording the first part of this video, but I wasn't. So yeah, this is our starting point. So here we go. So basically, this illustration is a mason jar with a miniature ecosystem in it. I like the idea of putting nature or just huge things in a small container. Like, you would never find like a house inside of a mason jar or a whole city inside of a mason jar unless it was like toys or something. I don't know. But I don't know. I just really think the concept is cool. I think I've seen it somewhere done before where you put, you know, it's something that you would normally find outside that you couldn't normally fit inside of a mason jar, and just, or just a jar, and you place it inside the jar. I don't know. I just really like that concept for some reason. But yeah, so here I'm just sketching it out using my mechanical pencil. I was debating on whether or not the perspective of this mason jar should be where, like, you're looking head on and you don't really see any curves to the top. Like, you don't see the top or the bottom of the lid, or, you know. And then I was like, I think I do want to add a little curvature to it so you can see the top of the lid a little bit. Mason jar, which is our first element. Here I'm drawing a chrysanthemum. I really like to draw those types of flowers, I'm not sure why. Those, roses, peonies. I just like to draw flowers in general, but chrysanthemums I think are my favorite to draw. And I'm just looking at the lid that I drew. It looks a little wonky. Sometimes it gets a little tricky to draw ellipses, you know, especially when you're drawing them at a certain size. The bigger you draw them, the more difficult it is to keep it as realistic as possible. To keep it not as wonky, I guess you could say. But it's clear, it's evident that I need more practice with drawing ellipses. I know a couple of tricks I could have used to do it, like draw within a square or a rectangle in perspective, and then drawing the oval to keep, you know, to get it more even. But you know, I just wanted to freehand. And I plan on turning this into a sticker design and maybe a print. I might just redo another one and make a print and, I'm sorry. I might just create another one and make that one into a print, because I think I want the print to be black and white. At the end, I'm coloring this with Copic markers. And I have to say, they're very nice. I think it's the sketch version, and they were quite expensive, you know, for some markers, I have to say, but I think they were well worth it, because the way they blend, you know, and the way they go down on this paper is very smooth. And yeah, I just really love the way the markers glide on this paper, this type of paper. It's Canson Bristol paper, so, and I just cut it, you know, in half to give this vertical look, because I want the jar to be Pretty tall. Not necessarily skinny, but I guess you could say skinny. And here I'm drawing a hummingbird. I really like to draw hummingbirds. I really like to draw birds in general, like owls and, you know, other birds, more so than like any other animal so far. And this was pretty fun to draw. And here I'm just messing with my phone. I forgot what I was listening to, but I need to change it. So sorry for the brief interruption. Here I had to kind of jump forward a bit, because if I didn't, this video would be way too long. So here I am outlining, basically retracing what I've already drawn with my Sakura Micron pens. I think this was a size 4 or maybe a 3. I was going over it with. And here I am about to speed up, so this video won't be so freaking long, I swear. And please ignore the top of my head and my face in this video. Oh my God. I'm just like, definitely was not trying to get that in there. Alright, so I have completed outlining this artwork, and my niece came in and just kind of scribbled on this, and I'm a little upset. I'm not sure if you can see it quite from here, but once I get closer up on it, you'll be able to see it, the slight marks. She went over it with a Sharpie, but what you gonna do? So here I'm just erasing my pencil marks underneath the Sakura Micron pens. And here I'm going in with one of the Copic markers. it just goes on so well. It feels so smooth to slide this marker against this paper, I swear. These are some of my favorite markers. I plan on getting a bigger collection of Copic markers, and I plan on getting the other versions of the of Copic. And I just really like this pink. I should have colored in the entire flower this color, but I was trying to do like a gradient, but the other pink that you're going to see that I used, it wasn't exactly the greatest match, but you know, what's done is done.
Music. Yeah.
everyone for watching this video. And if you could, subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell and leave a comment and a like, you know. And also share the video. If you really liked it, please share it. And also, if you want to, you can follow me on my Instagram at Pisces_illustrations. And you can watch my content on my IGTV as well. Because I'm uploading content, well, weekly content. And I just uploaded a video of me redrawing this very piece with my left hand. So it's a left hand challenge. So if you want to, like I said, please follow me on Instagram, follow me on Twitter, follow me on Facebook. And thanks for watching.